Howdy guys and gals, welcome back to the Social Regressive and a quick addendum to video number 4. I wanted to break this out into its own topic. We talked before about first focal plane versus second focal plane and which one you might want to choose for your situation. Some of it's personal preference, some of it is actually more of a function of what's going on in the environment, and make sure you don't miss that video. But in this one, we're going to talk about one extreme case and one that I think is going to be near and dear to a lot of your hearts. What we have right here are LPVOs, low power variable optics, or some of the AR scopes as you guys might know them. A lot of you guys have these on your defensive carbines, and these two, although they are very similar in a lot of ways, are very different. And both of them, I think, meet the challenge in a little bit different way, very, very brilliantly. All right, both of these are on the extreme side of the LPVOs. Most of the ones that you buy out there are going to be 1x up to 4x, so you have a 4x zoom ratio. These go from 1 to 8. That's going to make these a bit more expensive than those, and you're going to get a massive wide zoom ratio on these, and both of these are really good. I've used these both in the field with different types of rifles, and I love them. They both work great. But yeah, this one, the US Optics TS-8X, this has a first focal plane reticle, mil hash, and it has a circle kind of around the in the blank spaces for just kind of a thicker thing to look at. This is second focal plane, and it's very similar as well. This has a mil hash reticle that has quite a bit of drop attached as well, and it has a diamond in the middle. So first focal plane and second focal plane. These two actually accomplish the same things in a little bit different ways, and let me describe how. This one, since the reticle does stretch and shrink based on your zoom, so it's always going to measure exactly true to the target, is one that is going to have that, it's going to be able to make the hit that you want very precisely. You're going to, as long as you know your drops and you know your windage, you're going to be able to hold over, hold off, and make your hit, and it's going to work at no matter what zoom you have this set. But remember what I said about first focal plane and some of the drawbacks you can have when you have a high zoom ratio. When you are zoomed in on this, you're gonna have some pretty thick stadia. Those lines are gonna be pretty thick. And when you back off, they're gonna be very thin and actually very easy to lose. And on a defensive carbine, not being able to see your reticle is really bad. That's awful. But what they have done with this is they've created that circle that's much thicker than the rest of the stadia. So when you're zoomed out, you can see it. And more than that, since this has illumination, if you were to go into, you know, a firefight sort of situation where maybe you have to defend yourself, then what you can do is turn on the illumination and it practically becomes a red dot scope. You have this great big massive round red dot that you cannot miss at no matter what zoom. So even if I back this thing off to 1x, I have a beautiful reticle for being able to deal with whatever it is. So this would be great for hog hunting as well. I'm not gonna lose anything, even when I'm zoomed all the way out. Really, really great way to deal with that one drawback of FFP. Now SFP, like this one, this has the drawback of that reticle not working at all zooms. So if I am at 8x, my milliradian crosshair, my little stadia in there, they're going to measure true. That's where this actually measures a full milliradian per hash line. And then I have little intermediate ones in there as well. And it's all very pretty. Everything is set up, you know, just the right thickness, just like an SFP reticle should be. But when I zoom all the way out, that's when those lines aren't going to measure the right thing anymore. They're going to be measuring way too big. So it's going to be difficult for me to make a really long range shot on a target. But think about it. If you have one of these scopes on your rifle, what is it that you're actually going to be doing at 1x? Are you going to be shooting something a long way off? No, probably not. When you make your precise shot, you're probably going to be zoomed way in so you can actually see your target. So you're going to have it on 8x. But then if things are getting more dangerous and you're backing off to 1x, you're not worried about those little lines anymore. You're going to be using the center of that to make the hit. And that's exactly what happened in the hog hunt that we did out at the ranch a little while back. We were dealing with a herd of hogs, and I actually kept this thing on 1X, I think, the entire time. And it worked great because we were dealing with hogs that were either within 100-yard distance or closer, and I didn't want to zoom in any farther. But I've also used this to make some precise hits out at the range, cranking this sucker up to 8X. So both of these have dealt with their own drawbacks in their own individual ways, and this one actually does have illumination as well. So yeah, if I am in more of a defensive role, either against, you know, hogs or two-legged varmints, then I can turn on the reticle and the center dot and diamond in the middle, those illuminate red. So yeah, I am ready to go. Both of these are just really smart the way that they're set up. And whatever scope that you're looking at for your defensive carbine, just keep this in mind that maybe depending on your personal preference or your pocketbook, you may choose one over the other. For example, this one, the Falcon S8i, we're gonna do a full review on this. This is a $320 scope, I think, which is just insane for the quality that you get with this. The feature set, the glass, it is wonderful. And then this one, I think, with its first focal plane reticle, is about $650, somewhere in there. So you can kind of pick based on your pocketbook and what you want to get out of your individual scope. Thanks a lot for watching, you guys. This has just been a quick little addition there. If you have any other weird scopes that are like this that you're kind of wondering, okay, what about this one? Please leave a comment down below and maybe we can talk about that. But I thought this was probably the extreme case that a lot of folks would actually be dealing with their own carbines. Thanks a lot, you guys, and I'll see you in video 5. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks so much for your patronage.